Hello, everybody. Crystal, please. We're back with more My Little Blacksmith Shop. No time for BS. The time of wealth and greatness is upon us. I've got a little stockpile here now of one-handed grips, two-handed grips, and then some of the guards. I keep my pole arms up at this point. One of the things that we finally done is we've gotten enough money to afford tin, which is pretty sweet because, like I had said, the difference in the costs goes up really crazy. Again, when you go from copper, which is 10 each, to tin, which is 500 each, that's insane. And then the iron only goes up to it's only double instead of 50 times more. Oh, we got this very, very extravagantly dressed purple wearing folk coming over to us. I want to show you guys a little bit of the math too and kind of how it works. So this guy needs a dagger. So one of the things we're going to do real quick, I'm just going to buy one because it's all I can order right now. Oh, someone mentioned too, grab the box, throw it on the forge. I just knocked all the rest of my other copper out. Oh, whatever. Normally, I'm a little bit better at aiming up. I'll put these copper ones back up here for now. But with a dagger, all we need is one of these tin bars. So that's good. There's a few things that I've learned about kind of like what grips you have to use and things like that. And sometimes you can mess things up. So one thing that I found, I don't know why this is, but when we make this blade over here, if we use this blade or the second blade, everything is fine. If we use the much smaller looking third blade, things get wonky. So let's go ahead and throw a grip on this. Bam. And then, of course, get it stuck through the... Oh, boy. Get it stuck through the table. But I'm getting pretty good at pulling stuff out of the table. I'll tell you boys what. There we go. All right, so you can see right there. Well, right here. $563 for that. So what ends up happening is you can click on any of these items and it shows you exactly what the math is. So all that's really happening is the type of bar that you're using is multiplied by, you can see it right here, basically 10%, which gives us 550. So we get 50 out of the 500 that we spent of the tin bars. And then this other stuff happens down here. Now, right here, like, you're not really gaining a whole lot for getting grips. I'm kind of sad about that. You're not really gaining a whole lot for moving quickly or having a high charisma either. What I'd really like to see is if the charisma was a percentage instead of just, what do we have here? A one-handed sword. I don't think that we have enough for two tin, so we can go ahead and grind this guy out a quick one-handed sword. There's a couple of things that you could do. We don't have to change our blades because we already made a blade, so we can just keep this right like it is. I think I'm going to make this guy one of the, I don't know what you would call this. It kind of looks like a, falchion, maybe? I don't know. It's too thick for a saber, that's for sure. And it's definitely not what you would call like a katana or something like that. It reminds me a little bit of a falchion. Let me go ahead and grab this. We are going to grab a guard for this guy. Guard on the grip. Grip on the blade. And pull it out of the wall as we do. And here you go, sir. One delicious... Take it. One delicious one-handed sword. For real. Grab the sword, my man. Okay. Maybe we'll just... There we go. Now he's locked on. He's locked on to the sword. So P to level up. Something with the charisma not really doing very much right now. I think maybe we'll kind of like focus on agility to keep our speed up or something. I don't know. We'll try something new and exciting. We've done charisma. We got four levels of it right now. We start with the first level, I guess. So we got three levels of it right now. I don't feel like it's providing enough stuff. We got a couple of one-handed grips. We can buy others. People were saying you can throw a bunch of things into one box, and that's true. One of the things that I saw was here. We'll buy fancy one-handed grips for this. Was once you get, let's see here, what else do we want? Get a bunch of grips. Oh, we got a guy coming in too. I'll deal with him in a second. Let's see here. A pole arm. Okay. So for the pole arm, for this, we can, well, you know what? Hold on. You can do something cool with the pole arm. Let's go over here to the ingots and we'll do this as well. This is going to be pretty jacked up because we're going to have a box full of all kinds of crap in it, but that's fine. What I like to do is take my boxes inside now and then smash when I have guards and the like and then smash them in here. Kind of makes things a little bit easier putting the stuff on there. I do want to make this pole arm with the tin. Did I just buy a copper ingot? Well, that's, there you go. There's old Gray doing his thing. There we go. One tin ingot, if you please. I'd like to build this pole arm with the tin ingot, and knowing now that the speed at which you build this stuff just isn't that important, you can kind of just take your time if you want to. What does the rush really get you? I'd like to see the rush scaling with the cost of the ingots and such. So we're gonna need a blade for this. We can use pretty much any blade for our pole arm. I think you can use almost anything for the pole arm. So we'll just use one of these. Oh crap, we'll just use one of these again. We're gonna throw this over here. Get us a nice pole arm grip. It'll make a little bit of money off of this. There we go. And a pole arm for you, sir. This one's made out of tin now. You should be especially happy with that particular pole arm. And I imagine he was. There he is. $570 for that. So where did we get our extra money out of that time? The fancy pole arm grip. Okay, so that was all that made us extra money. Was a little bit of the pole arm. Look at this. $3.2 for rushing it. We give it our best, and what do we get? Absolutely nothing. Let's go ahead and... Whoa, that didn't work. Hold on. Let me test my basketball skills here. Ready, boys? Huh. Whoa. What are these grips made out of? There we go. I was going to say, it's like they're made out of rubber or something. Okay, so the throwing maybe doesn't work so well. Let's go ahead and walk over here and gently place them down. Like, just doing a single tap on them makes them go all crazy-like as well. Oh, boy. Over here in the land of blacksmith. Oh, what the hell? Oh, a great hammer. All right, hold on now. Hold on now. This is fine. We've got plenty of copper for delicious great hammers to be made. That's for sure. Now, the one thing that we are going to have to do... There we go. The one thing that we are going to have to do is make sure that we pick the appropriate head here. There we have it. All right, let's go ahead and smash one of these out. Now, unfortunately, the great hammer heads are not so impressively varied. You have basically this one. I think this is it. Yeah, you have this. That's it. So let's go ahead and grab this. Bring her over here. Grab our two-handed grip, and this should slide right in. There we have it. Now we're looking gimbly-like. There you go, future dwarf. Take your hammer. Can you take your hammer? Take your hammer. Let me see here. How about if I throw it on the ground? There we go. Okay, I think just throwing it on the ground and making them pick it up is a little bit better than what we're trying to do here. I'm going to finish putting these grips away. I'm pretty happy because we're almost at 1,000, and that means I'll be able to... Ooh, okay. One-handed hammer, so all we need is two ingots for this. I'm pretty happy because that means that we can start using two of the tin. So that's going to be really exciting because that's going to make us a bunch more money per shot. Oh, for the love of all that's holy. Come on now. Come on now. There we go. Hitbox on the old copper ingots. Every once in a while, it seems like it gets away from me. So my favorite hammerhead is this one. I like this one. It looks like a blessed hammer or something like that. Like one of them holy paladin-esque hammers, you know what I mean? I don't know what, if you guys play a lot of, or played a lot of MMOs in there, have you? Yeah, throwing it on the ground is the way to go. Holy crap, don't even hand it to him, just toss it. I don't know if you guys ever played a lot of MMOs and stuff like that, but I don't know what type of character was your favorite. In fact, feel free to let me know in the comment section what sort of character you like if you ever played those types of games, RPGs and the like, or if there's a couple of old school people out there, if you ever played old pen and paper RPG style games. One of my favorite critters to always play was healers and paladins. I always loved those things. Now the healer thing, I usually got pigeonholed into. I can see someone is walking toward us, doing the power walk here, the Olympian power walk. One of the things I always got pigeonholed into was just a regular healing role because no one ever wanted to do healing in any party or game I was ever a part of. It didn't matter if it was pen and paper. It didn't matter if it was RPGs picking up the great hammer, huh? All right, so we need... I'm going to go ahead and buy a bunch of copper ingots. In fact, I'm going to buy... I think the max you're allowed to buy is 10 at a time of any one type. So let's go ahead and throw this over here. Go ahead and give it the old slammy slam and then heat them up. We'll make that. In fact, while those are heating, watch this. We'll go ahead and grab a two-handed grip. So this is prepared for us. And when we come back here, they should almost be heated. Yep, they are. So let's go ahead and throw down this great hammer. We don't even have to change our head style. But anyway, no one ever wanted to play a healer. So I always ended up having to play the healers. And it got to the point where I got really good at them. I don't know. Like, I know it's hard to believe Gray being good at a video game. What in the hell? But no, I actually got decently good at healing in all these different games, and I started to, like, genuinely enjoy it. because of just how much I did it. Oh, the sun is setting or something. Holy cow, it is right in my eyes. Thank you, Mark. Mark's a donator, everyone. Now the Paladin, though, I always liked the idea because I feel like it's very, how do I say it? It was always, like, amongst the people that I played with, they were always very interested in playing evil people. I think it was just because it was a little bit easier playing an evil person because you didn't have to worry about always doing the right thing. So it was a little bit different to play a goody two-shoes instead of the other way around. So I kind of liked doing that. I was the voice of reason all the time. And my bunch of, we're all older now, but my group of people is, was always a friggin' handful. Let me tell you what, it's like herding cats. We've got the Sailor Moon hairstyle coming up here, and the beautiful rose glasses. A great sword, huh? We should have plenty of potential great sword stuff. I would say, what do we need to do? Like, one more of these, and then if we get a sword or something, we'll be able to buy the tin, which is gonna be really happy. I'm really happy to finally be able to do that, because like I said, we'll be making 100 a blade at that point, instead of, you know, only a couple bucks a blade like we're doing right now. I like this blade a little bit more. It just looks cooler. Oh boy. All right. I didn't. Let's try and get it into the water the right way. Someone said, oh, I'm trying to remember. They used the appropriate term for putting it into the water. Was it quenching or something like that? I'm trying to remember now. I'm sorry if I'm not doing you justice. Yeah, pick it up off the ground. That's how we do things. It's pretty late at night, boys. I think we should probably go to sleep for now. I'm going to get to the point where we have enough to make tin blades, and I'm going to show you guys that in a little bit. All right, I'm well rested. Let me show you guys something. Right over here. No time for BS. In fact, hold on now. It needs to be more overbearing than this. There we go. And let's see here. That's an interesting color. Yes. What do you boys think? Does the bright pink, do you think the bright pink will bring in all the adventurers? It's kind of weird, though, because we're a blacksmith, so we are BS. And yet, there's no time for BS. I don't know. That it almost sounds contradictory or something. Anyway, let me go ahead and get things sorted up here. I want to be selling some tin blades up in here today, boys. This is good. We've got a pole arm order. Oh, I'm just knocking boxes everywhere. Oh, Lord. Let me see here. Go ahead and heat this thing up. While we're at it, let's go ahead and... Oh, it looks like there is a shield icon, too. I wanted to tell you guys that. So hopefully, eventually, we'll be able to make shields. I'd really like for us to make shields and armor as well. I think that would be pretty sweet. Let's go ahead and grab this tin right here. Turn on our bladed thing. I think we're going to do the cool little two-pronged blade on this one. Not this one. But... Oh, come on now. This one. There we go. I hope you enjoy this pole arm there. Are you wearing all pink? Yes, you are. All right. Well, you know what they say. Pink is the color of the gods. Here you go. Oh, that was almost right in his hand. Did you see that? Or her, I guess. I say his, but her. There we go. $572 for that one. Made quite a little bit of money off of that. All right. Every once in a while, I've noticed too, not all the time, but every once in a while, the charisma bonus. Oh, it's Nina. Is a lot higher than normal. So, like, one time I had a charisma bonus of, like, 18, and I don't know why that was. There we go. We got a grand right now. So, if we can have someone that only needs a weapon that takes 2 bars, we can finally make a larger tin weapon. Oh, here we go right now. Look at this. Look at this athletic lass. She's coming up. Coming up to the No Time for BS shop. Yes, it's a little bit of rhetoric in there, I guess. But, okay, let's see what we got here. A dagger. Okay, we can definitely do a tin dagger. So, we're gonna have to buy, like, only one at a time every now and again because I want to get as much money off of these as possible right there. In fact, while that's, again, we can use a little bit of our time to grab one of these fancy grips. I think I just saw a grip go flying onto the ground. And look at that. Right by the time we came back, we were good to go. So, I'm gonna give this girl a matching blade to the last one right there because this is gonna be considered a dagger as well. But remember, the last type of blade that you can make for some reason was not considered a dagger. I don't really know why. There we have it. $568 for that one. Yeah, you see right there? The charisma bonus right there is 6. Let's keep an eye on that. I want to see if I can get it to change for you guys. There we go. We got someone coming up now. Remember, I also want to head back into the sandbox. You guys have given me some tips about getting into that ore in the sandbox. We're going to mess with that a little bit. We're going to see if we can make some fancier weapons over there and kind of test some of the mining out again. What do we got? A one-handed sword. Okay, this is perfect because we have just enough money. Look at this. To buy two of these. We can even buy one iron if, let's see. Are they both going to land on there? No, not really. Hold on. Let me see if I can get that one on there in time. We even have enough to buy one iron ingot, which is kind of interesting. I think iron comes next, and it should be 1,000. Yep, 1,000. So we're at the point where we can almost buy one of those. There's our heated tin and our other heated tin. And let's go ahead and blast this thing out. Now, what type of sword should we make this guy? I think there was a really thick-bladed sword. Hold on here. Let's see, there, like that there, kind of broadsword style, okay. This right here, look at this beefy thing. I think this might be a little bit too wide for a common blade. That might be kind of difficult to utilize. Let's go ahead and bring our grip over here. Do we have a, okay, good. We're running a little bit low on guards, so I probably need to think about that. And here we have our tin one-handed sword and Ref Basso grabbing that. Look at that right there. Now we're starting to make a little bit of cash. Our rush bonus was crap. But we got an extra 100 bucks just for the fact that we made that blade out of tin. So if we start getting one ingot orders, we can start on the iron. That's going to be cool. And then eventually, I'm hoping we can... Well, that 5,000, man. That's going to take a while. I'll tell you what. If you have the dedication, hold on guys, let me tell you guys something. If you have the dedication to grind your way, look at this, to $100,000 titanium ingots, you take a picture and you send it to my Twitter, because you will be the master of all that is blacksmith, cuz it will legitimately take forever, I feel. And a lot of that is just because of the scaling right now of the cache. Now, the developer had mentioned that he's looking for another update coming in August. Coming in April. I'm not exactly sure when, but I am really looking forward to that. I'm hoping that that has all the cool new stuff that we're hoping for. I'm going to use this one today. There we go. Hold on. There we have it. It looks like the water isn't always where you think it is. Now, we're going to have to buy more grips and stuff after this. You can see we've got this one guard left. Well, that went right on, and of course, it went right into the wall. Let's see here if we can put this on. Excellent. Let's go, and you got to pick it up, buddy. You got to pick it up off the ground. There it is, right in front of you. Right in front of you. Right here. Take it. Take it. Eat it. Eat the blade. Come on, man. There you go. You gotta, it's like a dog or something like that. You gotta lead him around for a little bit. All right, let me go ahead and restock our shelves. We're getting kind of low on guards. What do you think, boys? Square peg in a square hole? Can we get it in? Gray always can get it in. That sounded terrible. Let's go ahead and smash this thing open. Whoa, whoa. Okay. Oh, the pole arms are starting to fly. Wow. Okay, we just went flying. There you go, boys. I knew I could launch myself eventually. Actually, knowing this now, I'm going to have to bring like 35,000 pole arms outside. Give me a great hammer. We're going to have to bring like 1,000,000 pole arms outside one day. And I'm going to have to open the box and see if I can launch myself into the sky. Someone said, they were like, something's wrong. Gray hasn't managed to break the game yet. I'm getting there, man. I'll tell you, if I could get myself blasted like a rocket into the stratosphere, I'm getting somewhere. Let's go ahead and make this guy his weapon real quick. And then maybe we'll try one. We'll see if we can get one large tin weapon done. And then we'll go over into the sandbox. There you go. There's your great hammer. Just toss that right at you. And let me do a little bit of... If I kept this place like this, you guys would kill me. So let me go ahead and make everything look nice and pretty. What do you think of my stockpile, boys? Looking pretty good. We got a dagger to be made here, and since it's a one ingot item, we can actually go ahead and make it out of iron. I'm pretty excited about this for us to finally be moving into new ingot territory. Let's go ahead and smash this thing and get this iron ingot all lit up. While we're doing it, let's go ahead and grab a grip as well. Yeah, I purchased a whole bunch of everything, so we've got big towering slabs of all of the grips and stuff like that. Pretty happy about it. All right, iron ingot. Go right over there. I'm going to make the best dagger that you've ever seen. Here we go. And it's going to look just like this. Someone was saying that most blacksmiths lacked the skill to even make a weapon. So that's kind of interesting. So maybe we just have a couple of different recipes that we're using over and over again. So let's see here. So we just made our first iron dagger right there. Charisma bonus of 6. Oh, let me show you guys something. So there's a charisma bonus of 6. Look at this. Charisma bonus is 12. Also, this was really weird because this showed as a tin greatsword, but the actual details was a hammer. I just made a hammer, and for some reason it's counting it as a greatsword, but whatever. We're at the point now where we can afford 3 tin ingots if we want to. So that is going to be cool. I'm hoping to be able to make a full tin weapon here in a minute. All right, we got a pole arm that we can make. So we can make this out of iron as well because all we need is one. So let's go ahead and grab one of these like that. And I think the next level up is what, 5,000 coins or dollars or whatever you want to. I feel weird that it's dollars. It should be like gold coins or something like that. Maybe we should call it gold coins or something. It just seems a little bit more legit than saying dollars. Let's go ahead and throw this thing over here. And blades. I think we had a blade last time. Oh, we did. But whatever. I just want to be doubly sure here. We're going to give you the weird swippy blade. Oh, by the way, I want to show you guys. So if I can hit this thing. That's the one that gave me trouble. That last one there. That really tiny blade. That gave me a lot of trouble before. It didn't see. I think it works for a pole arm, but it definitely didn't work for a dagger. That's for sure. That was quick. You're darn right it is. I have so much experience making this crap now. You better know, boy. So another 6 charisma bonus for that. 1,100. All right. So now we're up past $1,600. All right. We need a great hammer. So this is it. This is going to be our first full tin great hammer. So let's go spend all of our money, basically. You can see we're down to 141 delicious coins. And there we go. There goes all the tin. While we're doing this, we can go ahead and put the two-handed grip over here. Now, if you want, you could grab your grip first as you're swinging around over here to the anvil. That works as well. Let's see. The tin ingot there. That's copper. Oh, I just got smashed in the face with a tin ingot. Hold on. It's a heated tin ingot. But luckily, we're so skilled at being a blacksmith that a little bit of, like, white-hot tin isn't enough to stop us. All right. Our very first full-sized tin weapon. Here we go. And right there. There's that tin large hammerhead. I want that big money here, boy. Oh, let's go ahead and get that big money. Here you are. Here you are, ma'am. Drevel. And there we go. That was our first one. We got, wow. Oh, there we go. Made us an extra 150 right there, plus a couple of extra bucks. And then we're up to 1,800. Okay, so we are almost at the 2,000 mark. And I think we need 5,000 for this, though. Yeah. So at the 2,000 mark, we can start making 2 ingot iron items. But anyway, I said we were going to go back over to the sandbox area. Well, you know what? Let's get this last order in. We'll get this last. I'd hate to leave this guy out in the cold. We'll get this last order in, and then we'll head over to the sandbox area. Mess around there real quick. All right. Love the hairstyle. A lot of glasses wears here. I don't know if this is because people have poor eyesight or because it's very sunny outside. Let's go make a nice iron dagger here. Since we can. Smash-a-doo. Heat it up. Go ahead and bring a nice grip over here. You're going to get an average grip today. In fact, I think I have a lot of average grips on me. And heated iron. Sweet. We got to change, though. Remember, we were on blunts last time. Now, there is no 1 ingot blunt weapon, so you don't really have to worry too much about failing there. All right. Man, we've got this process down pretty pat. I'll tell you what. Here's your dagger, ma'am. There you go. Nice iron dagger. A beautiful iron dagger for a beautiful lass. Let's see here. That was Laura. Thank you, Laura. All right, let's go head over to the sandbox area and see what we can do over there. Oh, look at this. Forestry test field. Not implemented. Oh, there's a forestry test field over here. I'd never walked all the way back there, so I didn't really know what to expect. Kind of interesting. Man, you guys say that my work area is messy. Look at this. There's just stuff laying everywhere. We got some grips on the ground. There's like copper ingots all over the damn place. There is a whole slew of guards and things. Oh, look at this. We got a beautiful mithril boulder. What in the world is going on over here? What is this? Why was all this on fire? Over here in the side. This is very strange. Got a little heated short blade and such over there as well. What sort of rocks do we have? See, we've got, oh, there's the Adalite, and there's tin and copper. Copper. I think we'll hack away at the Mithril. Now, you guys were saying that you have to, like, crack open the Mithril and then get at the stuff inside. So, let's give it a couple hits here. So, let's see. We'll peel all this, peel this crap away. So, now, let's see. Now, get that out of there. So, which people? Whoa! All right, hi. Hi, Mithril Boulder. Wow, okay, pieces are flying everywhere. So now, which pieces of this count? Let's see, that's not it. These are all just regular chunks over here. Let's go ahead and beat this thing down a little bit more. Go ahead and kind of break it. Oh, wow, hold on. You can legitimately, like, waggle this thing all over the place. Come here, get out of here. Get, fire it up, and then, like, that there. Oh boy, I don't know, guys. I don't know if that's correct. I think this may be an instance where, I know you guys said that it's in the middle. I'm not seeing anything though. We just beat the crap out of that Mithril Boulder and there was nothing in the middle. Here we have a new fangled Mithril Boulder. How about, there we go. Cool Mithril ore, look at that. This time it worked just fine. So the first Mithril Boulder, It did not at all enjoy what we were putting down. All right, let's do this. Yes! Now it's working. Okay, we've got another piece of cooled Mithril. In fact, you know what? I want to make something cool. Let's make the biggest pole arm we can. Hold on here, because I think we can do it. We're going to get some more. Where's some more Mithril pieces at? I don't want all this junk. Get all this junk out of the way. Where's the good Mithril pieces? Oh! I feel bad because while I was trying to mine for more Mithril, We ended up crashing the game, but it did say that this could potentially crash the game. But look at this, we got an adamantine boulder right here. Now it looks like. Hold on, let me kind of throw some of these pieces off here. It looks like you don't always get ore, out of the item. Like you can kind of like shuffle everything around here, and like sometimes pieces will fall onto the ground, but you don't always seem to get it. So oh, right there, we got one piece right there. Hold on. See if I can get, if we can get a second piece, that would be like awesome. If we get a second piece of ore. I don't know though. Hold on here. We got a couple of rocks kind of here in the middle. Don't mind if I do. Don't mind if I just willy-nilly throw this thing everywhere. Wow. Look at the strength of our blacksmith. It's insane. And I think that that's pretty much it. Okay. So what did we get? We got two pieces of adamantine ore. Ooh. Okay. You know what? Let's see if we can put this together real quick. We'll put together an adamantine sword or something like that. Well, actually, we could still make our glaive. We just won't be able to make it out of the greatsword style. But you know what? Whatever. Oh, this is titanium! Titanium! Oh, you know what? Hold on. I don't want to do this because if I do this, I could crash the game. Let's go make our adamantine thing first. So let's do this first, and then we'll worry about the titanium. All right, so put this over here. Slap this right here. Now this should melt right into ingots. Come on now. Oh, while this is going on, we're gonna want to make sure that we can choose our yes, right there. Sweet. Oh, we gotta heat them up too. Forgot about that. Now that they've melted down into the ingots, we've gotta heat it up so that they're heated so we can actually use them. And then we'll go ahead there, right there. Put that right there. And then one more. We'll go ahead and make a blade. What is this? Shields. Hold on. I didn't know this was here. You can make a shield? Can you? Whoa. What is this? Shield rim? I had no idea this was even here. Can you make anything else? Hold on. I can't seem to pull it off is the only. All right, hold on. Let me see if I can whirly gig this around real fast. Oh, wow. A shield rim. Now, this doesn't appear, like you don't have to cool it or anything, it's just there. So this may be, this is the very first bit of what we're gonna be allowed to do with shields. Oh, how do you like that? Is there anything else I can buy? Like anything weird over here that there's not normally here? Hold on, let me check this out. No. And then all the ingots seem normal. So I'll bet what it is the forestry section will have you chopping down wood maybe so that you can get the rest of the items for that. Oh, that's so cool. Hold on, let me try this titanium thing over here real quick. Actually, let's try a few things. So we had two pieces of adamantine that made that shield rim. So what happens if, say, we do like one ingot? What does this make? And then what happens if we do three? Oh, a shield boss. Hold on, man, things are coming together. Hold on, things are coming together. I'm starting to figure things out here. Let's put this up here and put this up here. So now, what happens if we get three pieces of ore and we make something? What do we have the most of? I think we have a lot of tin out here. I think we have a lot of iron out here too. We have this adalite out here. Got some more iron. Okay, let's see if we can get up iron. So we're gonna need three pieces. We're looking for three cooled ore pieces. Break all this up. I don't know if this actually helps or not, like knock it out. It looks like when the ore comes out, it literally just rockets out. So we didn't get anything there. How about this adalite boulder? Can we get anything out of this? We need three pieces. Now, if not, we can jump back in real quick and try this again. Hold on here. Let me kind of mess all this up and see if we can get something. Okay, we got three pieces of cool tin. Hold on. Let's see what happens here. Let's go ahead and put all this tin down here, and we'll see if we can finish up this shield. I'm really curious about this. All right, boys, here we go. This is the last go. Let's see what we can do here. All right, so do that. Make sure that we have our shield selected, and then let's check this out. All right, here we go. There's the big hit. Will this give us the shield face, I wonder? I don't know, man. Come on, baby. Oh, no. Oh, I don't think it's gonna give us anything. Oh, that would be cool, though. Oh, that sucks. All right, so it looks like right now we can make the shield boss and we can make the shield rim, but we can't make the rest of the shield yet. But that's cool. So the shield is definitely being implemented, that's for sure. So if we get rid of one of these, is that just going to give us the shield rim again, I'm guessing? I think that's what it gave us last time, didn't it? Yep, right there, shield rims. Okay, so it looks like that's on the way. That'll be awesome. Guys, hope you enjoyed this episode of My Little Blacksmith Shop. New cool stuff coming, that's for sure. Until the next time, folks, stay foxy and much love.